The thing that we're going to learn today is one of the 13 principles. One of the 13 principles of the basic of Judaism. And it's the 12th one, which is Mashiach. So everybody knows the famous song about Ani Ma'amin Be'emunah Shlema Be'viat HaMashiach. We'll try to enhance our understanding, deep our understanding, because this is a real mitzvah that the more you understand it, the more you could perform it. Okay. So first, the 13 principles. Let's just talk about them in general. If we divide them, the 13, we could divide them to three groups. The first five speaking about the Creator, about Hashem, what we should know about Him, what we could and should know about Him, that He exists, that He is unique, that He is not material, meaning He's not limited by time and space or any limits. Therefore, He is, was there forever, will be there forever, and that Isur Avodah Zarah, that you're not allowed to work, worship, be mevatel yourself to something else but Hashem. So those are the first five principles of the 30. The next group, the second group, is the next four. And this is speaking about the Torah. That there is such a thing called prophecy, nevuah, that Moshe Rabbeinu is above and in different category in the prophecy from the other Nevi'im. And the Torah was given from Hashem, the entire Torah, Torah Shebichtav and Torah Shebaal Peh, the oral Torah and the written Torah, and the Torah is not going to change, and it's forever the way it is. Those are the four principles in the second group, which speak about the Torah. Again, the first five, speaking about Hashem, about the Creator, the second group, speak about the Torah, and the last four, speaking about the reward system, Ma'arechet HaGmul, that Hashem aware of everything that's happening. There is a reward system because there is a free will, and this is the purpose of the creation. And part of this reward, in the big picture, are the last two. Biyat HaMashiach and Tchiyat HaMetim. Mashiach at the end of days, which will be the reward, the ultimate reward, and Tchiyat HaMetim and the existing forever in Olam Haba. Okay, those are, in general, this is the overview picture of the 13 principles. From all of them, we will emphasize today the 12th principle, which is Mashiach. Everybody knows about Mashiach, but we could know more. And this is the purpose of this shiur. You should know that the source of the 13 principles is actually the Rambam. The Rambam put them together. And he explained each one of them in details in the Hakdama that he wrote for Perek Chelek in Masechet Sanhedrin. Let's read just in general, maybe not every word, that will explain the idea about what he says about the 12th principle. ימות המשיח, והוא להאמין ולאמת שיבוא. We should believe, and it should be sure for us, that Mashiach will come. And even if he will delay, and it will be long time to wait, we should wait. And the Rambam says over here, you should not calculate the time. Don't try to figure out what is the time, because the time is above our ability to really know it for sure. Therefore, we should wait and anticipate, even though the date is not known. It could not be known. What we have to know is that we have a deadline. The deadline is the end of the 6,000 years. And it's very close to us now, because we are now in the year Let's see if I have it over here now. Okay. We are now in the year 5775, which it leave us with another 225 years. But we have to know that after Mashiach, there is more things on the agenda. So meaning the Mashiach will not come at the last moment of the 6,000 because he has to do a lot of things before that. Therefore, every day that passing brings us closer to the deadline of to the time when Mashiach will come. So we have to wait, and we should not calculate or try to figure out the time. And the Rambam brings you here the Gemara in Masechet Sanhedrin that says, "Tipach rucham shel mechashvei kitzim." There's something not good that Chazal says about those people who try to calculate it. Now, what Mashiach will be? This is one of the things. Ve'she'yamin she'yeh lo yitaron ma'ala bekavod al kol ha'melachim she'ayu me'olam. It will take the great kings that Hashem chose for the Jewish people, David HaMelech, Shlomo HaMelech, Mashiach will be more than them. He will be more than David HaMelech and more than Shlomo HaMelech. And all the other Melachim Tzadikim that was in the past. כפי מה שניבו עליו, עליו השלום, עליו כל הנביאים, עם משה רבנו עליו השלום, עד מלאכי עליו השלום. We could find relating in the Tanakh by the words of Moshe Rabbeinu and the other Nevi'im, including Malachi. Malachi is the last Navi, Malachi is Ezra. Ezra is his name in the Ketuvim, Malachi is his name in the Nevi'im. And the last few psukim of Malachi are very famous. הנה אנוכי שולח לכם את אליה הנביא, לפני בו יום השם הגדול והנורא, which is the time when Mashiach will come, and אליהו הנביא will come, when Mashiach to tell us who is the Mashiach. Okay, about this we'll speak later. Okay, now, the Rambam explains what the obligation of us. ומי שיסתפק בו, או נתמעט אצלו מעלתו, כפר בתורה. If somebody have doubts, any Jew have doubts if Mashiach will come, yes or no, have doubts, not sure, yes, doubts, this is a kfirah ba'ikar, kafar ba'torah. The other thing that he mentioned over here, on itma'et etzlo ma'alato, meaning that he will say, okay, but he will not be that great, more than David HaMelech, more than Shlomo HaMelech. Both of those things, if somebody has doubt about it, it's a kfirah ba'torah. And this is the meaning of ikar. You probably aware of the notion kafar ba'ikar, right? From Agadah shel Pesach. Mm-hmm. Ikar is a sort. Actually, it's a root, like a tree. A root has the root. So the Rambam brings 13 roots, and each one of them, if you do not sure about it, it's kfirah ba'ikar. So here it's a kfirah ba'ikar shel Mashiach, in the 12. Principle, if you have doubt about it, or you do not think that he will be the greatest from all the one that was before. Okay. Fine. So those are the words of the Rambam in Perek Chelek when he explained this principle of Mashiach. Now, we sang it in Yigdal also. Yigdal Elokim Chai, right? The famous Yishlach leketz yamin Mashiachenu לפדות מחכה קץ ישועתו. We sing that in the Tefillat 18 every day also, different nuschot, but in Tzemach David, I believe this is in the Sfarad, את צמח דוד עבדך מרת עצמיך וקרנות ארום בישועתך, כי לישועתך קיווינו וציפינו כל היום. So the Yeshua that we anticipate, ציפינו, is Mashiach. Mashiach is the one who will solve all the problems and bring us to the optimal state. Another thing that you're probably aware of is this Gemara in Shabbat. You probably heard it many, many times in different occasions. Amar Rava, b'sha'a shemachnisim adam ladin. We're talking here about 120. After 120, when a person leaves this world, each person will be asked those questions. The fourth question is Tzipita Lishua. So the first one is Nasata Venatata Be'emunah, you were honest in your business, when you did business, קבעת עיתים לתורה, עסקת בפריה ורבייה, ציפית לישועה, פלפלת בחוכמה, הבנת דבר מתוך דבר. Okay, those are the questions, and one of them is ציפית לישועה. Now we have to know, it's not just a slogan, this is a real obligation. Each one of us should be in a state that they were waiting for Yeshua, for salvation. Of course, if you in a situation or in a state of mind that everything is fine, everything is great. So what are you looking for? You are not looking for Yeshua. So in order to be Tzipita Yeshua, we have to understand that we are not in the right place. Not just right place technically, physically, but we are not in the right state, situation. And this is the mitzvah. I mean, this is the thing that I think most important to understand about this waiting for Mashiach. Waiting for Mashiach meaning that we are not good now, and we are not good, not just, you know, it's not just a little bit not comfortable. To wait, to anticipate, meaning that you're anxious. You really feel not comfortable. And unfortunately, that's not the situation of many people today, even from. I mean, everything is fine, good, everything is running. We do not really feel the need now of going back to Eretz Yisrael, having Bet HaMikdash. Everything should be in the right state spiritually. And this is the mitzvah. It's a mitzvah that we have to work on ourselves to be aware how the situation of today, the current situation, is not the optimal one. And even not just not the optimal, it's not good. And this is the mitzvah to wait for Mashiach. Now, when we're waiting for Mashiach, what Mashiach going to do? This is also one of the things that we should know. I mean, what are we really waiting for? That a person will come and what? And will send us in first class to Eretz Yisrael. What Mashiach going to change? Okay. Before that, let's see a few more sources about the words, where Chazal took those words. We said, I mean, in Ani Ma'amin, we're saying, Ani Ma'amin be'emunah shlema beviyat ha-Mashiach, ve'af al pi she'yitmameh, im kol ze achakeh lo bechol yom she'yavo. Af al pi she'yitmameh, even if it will delayed and delayed and delayed. Achakeh lo. Those words, be aware of those words, yitmameh ve'achakeh lo. I will wait for him, even if he will delay. I want to show you the source of it in the Tanakh, in the psukim in the Tanakh. In Sefer Chavakuk, פרק ב', it says, ויענני השם ויומר, כתוב חזון. חבקוק הנביא says that השם told him, write down this vision. ובער על הלוחות. Write it down in a very clear place. למען ירוץ קורא בו. When somebody will read it, it will be clear to the reader. כי עוד חזון למועד. This vision will not be now. It will be in long time. ויפח לקץ ולא יחזב. Don't worry, even though it will take time, at the end it's going to happen. And here are the words of the Navi. אם יתמהמה, חכה לו, כי בו יבוא. This is the sort of אף על פי שיתמהמה, אם כל זה חכה לו. אם יתמהמה, even if it will take time, I will wait for him. Why? כי בו יבוא. He will come. לא יאחר, meaning he will not go over the deadline. At the end, it will come. Now, the tricky thing about Mashiach, or about the Geula in general, that there are two times for the Geula. Be'ita and Achishena. Meaning, there is a time that no matter what, when this time will come, Mashiach will come anyways. But there is an option that Mashiach will be, or Geula will come before, earlier. And it's up to the balance of our merits. So, because of this, there is extra thing to anticipate. We have to anticipate. This is the meaning of ואף על פי שיתמהמה בכל יום אחכה לו. Why בכל יום? If there is a time, why every day? Even you have to wait for the day. So the explanation of this is that there are two dates. The date and the ability that it will come before. Therefore, you have to wait every day. Okay? Another place in the Tanakh, aside from Habakkuk, on these words, yeah, are in Sefer Daniel. V'ata Daniel, at the end of Sefer Daniel, at the last chapter, Perek Yud Bet, Hashem shows Daniel something. And Daniel says, this is not in the Pesukim over here, Daniel saw a vision about the redemption, the Geula at the end of days. And Daniel says the following, V'ani ra'iti ve'lo avin. I saw, but I didn't understand. I don't understood. And I asked for meaning, for explanation. And he was told, Daniel, V'ata Daniel, stoma dvarim v'chatoma sefer. It will not be explained. Just write them down. Ad et ketz yeshotetu rabim v'tirbe adat. Just write it down. It has to be written. It could not be understood. But when it will happen, retroactively will be understood. And retroactively, everybody will know that it was written there. Now, Daniel, after that, says the following. Ashrei ha-mechake, again, ha-mechake. Lucky is the one who is waiting. Ve'yagia le'yamin. And he will get to this date. And now here, Daniel bring a date. Or bring number. About this number, all G'dayla Yisrael during the history try to understand what this number, because is if you understand what's written over here, or this number, 1,335, if you understand this, you understand when Mashiach will come. But I have to tell you that all the attempts so far was failed. And we're talking about great scholars of the Jewish nation during the history that tried. And Hashem says in advance, it will be unknown until it will come.
My grandfather was a big tzaddik. He told me,
who?
My grandfather. Mm-hmm. He told me that those who say don't know and those who know don't say.
Right. That this is the definition of secret. Secret is secret. Those who say do not know, those who know that don't say. But actually, nobody knows. Actually, really, nobody knows. ואתה לך לקץ, השם says to Daniel, ותנוח ותעמוד לגורלך לקץ הימין. And here's another very interesting thing about this קץ הימין. People who speak Hebrew could mix the ימין with ימים. And says, you know what, noon, man. No, it's written over here, ימין. And even in Yigdal, he said, ישלח לקץ ימין. It's not a mistake. It's not a mistake, it's on purpose. And the meaning of here is not yamim days, but yamin right. Right. And to understand this, there's a pasuk in Micha, in Megillas Eicha, that says, Heshiv achor yemino. It's speaking about the Churban. And it says that, kivyachol, that Hashem took his strong hand. We have two hands, the right usually is the stronger, and Heshiv Achor Yemino, he put his strong hand, meaning the Gvura of Hashem, he put it away. Why? Because of the sins of the Jewish nation. Hashem could not but give them the punishment, and it shows that Hashem could not protect. It looks like he could not protect his nation. Therefore, the Yamin is behind. When the Yamin will go back again to the front, this is Ketz HaYamin. This is Ketz HaYamin. The end of the time that the Yamin is back, it will be back in front. Okay, this is the meaning of this. Okay?
When we read Beparshat Vayetze al Amalek, as Katuv Ki Yad
Al
Ketz Hashem Amalek Midor Vador, I don't remember exactly the pasuk.
Ki yad al keskia
milchama
la Hashem ba'amalek midor.
So I'm just thinking, it says about the yad over there, which is also very parashas tuma. Af had lo mevin. Yichol liyot shezot hayad shebeketz hayamim, Hashem, hayad shel Hashem,
it's the same yad, but the meaning, the simple understanding of what's written over there in parashat Amalek is, okay, the simple understanding is Hashem swear. When you swear, you take your hand, and Hashem kivyachol hold his kiseh kavod ki yad al kesya milchama la Hashem v'amalek. But it's the same yad. It's the same yad. Yes.
What does it mean? His hand is behind him. Will come to the front.
That's what I said. That
what does it mean?
Because of the sins of the Jewish people, and because there is a judgment system, Hashem, it looks like Hashem could not protect his Jewish nation and allow the Babylonian, Megillat Eicha was written for the destruction of the first Beit HaMikdash by the Babylonian, Hashem let Nebuchadnezzar to destroy Beit HaMikdash. And that, this event was described by Yirmiyahu HaNavi, who wrote Megillat Eicha, like Hashem put his right hand behind his back. Ketz HaYamin is when it will be the end of the time of the hand to be behind, and it will come back to the front, okay? Okay, let's continue. Now, the Nevuah Moshea says the following, and here it's very interesting. Ki yamim rabim, Hoshea Navi speaks about it before the destruction of Beit HaMikdash HaRishon. Ki yamim rabim yashvu bnei Yisrael, this is a vision to the end of days. Ki yamim rabim yashvu bnei Yisrael, en melech, will be no king, ve'en sar, ve'en zevach, ve'en matzeva, will be no korbonos, ve'en efod utrafim, which is the Kohen Gadol with the Urim Tumim. Yamim rabim, it will take long time, many days, achar, be aware of the following, achar, after those long days, achar yashuv bnei Yisrael, uvikshu et Hashem Elohim, ואת דוד מלכם, ופחדו אל השם ואל טובו, באחרית הימים. So Hoshea speaks about אחרית הימים, and he said, for many, many days, and we today know how many days passed. Many days. No king, no בית המקדש, no קורבנות, but what will be at the end? After those ימים רבים, ישובו בני ישראל. And here is what we should do. We should ask, Yashuvu Bnei Yisrael uvikshu. They should be in such a state that they will beg and ask and daven and pray that Hashem will bring three things. Uvikshu et Hashem Elohim, the kingdom of Hashem. Ve David Malkam, that will have a king, meaning not David himself, but the descendants of David, which is Mashiach. By the way, this is the meaning of David Melech Israel Chai Vekayam. What do you mean, Chai Vekayam? He passed away. But because Hashem promised him that when the Jewish people will be redeemed, it will be always by one of his descendants, it's like he exists forever. Chai Vekayam. Okay? So the second thing that we have to ask, aside from the Malchut Hashem Ba'olam, is Malchut Beit David, which is the human representative of Malchut Hashem when he will be the ruler of Am Yisrael. And the other thing, Upachadu el Hashem ve'el tuvo be'acharit ha'yamim. Now to explain why there are three things and what the meaning of them, let's go to Rashi. Achar yashuv bnei Yisrael, says Rashi, Achar yemei ha'gola, after the time of the exile. Yashuv bnei Yisrael uvikshu et Hashem. Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya. And here Rashi bring the Chazal bring the from the Gemara. Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya, en marim siman tov liYisrael ad sheyachzeru v'yivakshu shloshtam. When will be the sign of the Geula? When the Jews will beg for those three things. What are they? Achar yashuv bnei Yisrael uvikshu et Hashem zo malchut shamayim. Ve'David malkam kemashmao malchut ve'David. Now what is the meaning of ופחדו אל השם ואל טובו באחרית הימים. ופחדו אל השם ואל טובו זה בית המקדש. כמה דאיתמר ההר הטוב הזה והלבנון. הר הטוב זה בית המקדש. פחדו אל טובו.
What's the literal translation of פחדו here?
Yes, that's a good question. This is the next slide. So, there are the three things. The three things again. מלכות השם, בעולם, we have to understand that the Geula is not just to redeem the Jewish people. It's to redeem the creation and actually fix the thing that ruined the creation in the beginning of the history, which is Chet Adam HaRishon. So the Geula will be a fix of Chet Adam HaRishon and bringing the entire creation to its real state, what it should be. This is Malchut Hashem. This is Vaya Hashem Lemelech Al Kol Haaretz. By al kol ha'aretz, al kol ha'olam, for the entire universe, everybody will understand or recognize Malchut Hashem. This is the one thing. The other thing is Malchut Bet David. Malchut Bet David relate to the Jewish nation. The Mashiach, we will see, the job of the Mashiach is to finish the exile and bring the Jews back to where they belong, technically, to the land and to the state where they belong, to the level. This is the job of Mashiach, and this is Malchut Bet David. The other thing is Beit HaMikdash. And this is Pachadu El Tuvo. What's Pachadu? Says HaMetzudot. Acha, on the same pasuk, Metzudot David. Acha, Rotze Lomar. Achar Yamim Rabim, after many days, Yeshuvu Bnei Israel El Arzam, to their place, to their land. Ve'az Yevakshu Et Hashem Lish'ol Mimenu Tzorkam, Ki Yeshuv V'Yashre Shechinato Beneim. They will understand, each individual and the nation in general, will understand that the only source that give us what we need is Hashem. It's not Kochi V'Otzem Yadi, it's not this state or this king or this country or this power, superpower, only Hashem. So this is the thing. Ve'David Malkam, ve'gam yevakshu et melech ha-mashiach haba mizera David u'mimenu yevakshu she'elatav. Ki hu imshol bem, ve'lo imloch bem od melech Yisrael mishevet acher. לא כמו מאז שמלך עליהם ירובעם ושאר מלכי אפרים. So, he explained the following. Every Jew in the world will understand that only Mashiach ben David, only this king, should be the king. By the way, technically, or if we want to make it relevant to our generation, to our time, many people, even from, think mistakenly, that kingdom or king is passé, is old-fashioned. Who needs kings today? By the way, kings are a problem because many, many kings, not just in the Jewish nation, in the history, they got too much power and they become dictators and they did terrible things. So today the environment is, you know what? It's good that we have no more kings. Democracy is the solution. Because in democracy, there is an illusion that we have an influence about the leader. We chose the leader. If he's not good, we're throwing it after 4 years or 8 years. So people could mistakenly think this is the optimal system. This is the optimal system. Who needs kings? It's old-fashioned. We do not have to think about it anymore. Wrong.
Unless you're English, like me. We have king, we have queen.
You know what, even in England, it's just, it's not the king, the queen of England is not running the country, is not getting the decisions. It's just, a puppet.
We love the idea of a monarchy, we really do.
Okay, we have to know, as Jews, we have to know that nothing less than a king who goes in the Derech Hashem, in Derech HaTorah, king that Hashem will choose, it's not we who choosing our king according to political hashkafa, I think this person is better. It's not going like this. Hashem is the one who chose the king. Who chose the king? And we should be in this understanding. This is part of anticipation of Mashiach. Tzipit al Yeshua, that all other systems are wrong, including democracy. Even though it seems with benefits, but there are many shortcoming also for this system. And we have to know that the only system that we should really wish for is king. King, meaning the right king, Mashiach ben David, that will lead us, not according to his ideas, but to the Torah, through the Torah, because he will be obligated to the Torah and he will be the representative of Hashem here. This is part of the thing that we should know. I said, the entire shiur is to understand more what we should do with this principle of waiting for Mashiach. So we have to understand that this is it. Okay, that's what the Mitzvah says.
Just a quick question, please. Why is it when they came back from Babel, there was not a king chosen then? Supposedly, at that time, it was Shiva Zion, and it was supposed to be Beit HaMikdash was built. And let's say we would have stayed there already. Why wasn't the king chosen then?
Because Beit Sheni was not a redemption. Beit Sheni was a temporary thing. Beit Sheni was built when the people who built it cried. It's mentioned in the Tanakh. Why they cried? The old people who saw the first Beit HaMikdash cried because they said, no, come on, this is a substitution. And more than that, they knew in advance that it's not the ultimate Geula. They knew it's temporary, and one of the things, five things was missing in the Bayit Sheni that was not, was in Bayit Rishon, but was not in Bayit Sheni. And aside from the, it, the fact is that was no king during the entire time of Bayit Sheni from David. Later on, in the middle, when the Hashmonaim, which was who were Kohanim from Shevet Levi, they took the kingdom forcefully and they got punished for this. And then came Hordus, which was one, he was a Ger, a Domi, he was not the right one. Anyway, the entire time of Bayit Sheni was no king from Zera Ben David. Therefore, we have to know that we still have to wait for the redemption that will be in the next Beit HaMikdash, the last Beit HaMikdash, which is Bayit Shlishi, and then will be Mashiach Ben David.
But let's continue. Initially, we were not supposed to have a king. It's only because the people asked for it, and Hashem was upset.
It's not accurate, but I don't have time to... In the Torah, it says, in the Torah, before Shmuel HaNavi, before David HaMelech, Hashem says that you have to put a king. That it was, when they asked it, they didn't ask it right. But it's not just because they're right, they asked. It's by itself. Hashem says in the Torah that you have to put a king. Okay, let's continue. So, ufachadu el Hashem. Here's the explanation of what you asked before. Why? What is the meaning of pachadu el Hashem ve'el tuvo? So we said in Rashi that tuvo is Beit HaMikdash, right? What pachadu? Pachadu is fear. Fear. Explain the Metzudot. Pachadu el Hashem, as yifchadu et Hashem ve'el tuvo, רוצה לומר, he meant to say, לא יחטאו עוד. They will not sin anymore. Why? כי יפחדו את השם שלא יסיר שכינתו מביניהם. ויפחדו את טובו שלא יאבדו השפעת טובו. We had בית המקדש. We had בית ראשון. We had בית שני. We lost it. Why we lost it? Because we, as a nation, has a lot of sins. Hashem says, אם בחוקותיי תלכו ואת מצוותיי תשמרו ועשיתם אותם, וישבתם לבטח בארצכם. He said that before we entered the country in the first time, by the time of Moshe Rabbeinu. If you will not do it, והשימות יהיה את הארץ, ושממו על אויביכם, והשימות יהיה את מקדשכם, I will destroy the בית המקדש. After the big lesson that we're going to have for a long time in the exile, when the real redemption will come at the end of days, and we will know that there is a base of Mikdash now, we will do everything not to lose it again. And this is the pachad. The pachad is yirat shamayim, which is in awe, or fear also, that we are not, chas v'shalom, gonna lose it again. And because we understand why did we lose it, because of the sins, there will be no sins anymore. That's what he explains over here. This is upachadu el Hashem ve'el tuvo ba'acharit hayamim. Now, here, more details that the Rambam bring about what Mashiach is going to do when he will come. Let's see. Yamot HaMashiach, the time of Mashiach, who was man shetashuv ha-malchut li-Israel ve-yachzeru le-Eretz Israel. So this is the thing that's going to happen, that the Jews will come back to Eretz Israel and they will have a king from David. V'hi oto ha-melech gadol me'od. He will be a big, great king. Uvet malchuto be-Tzion. His place is palace will be in Zion, in Yerushalayim. Yigdal shmo v'zichro yiyem melo agoyim yoter min ha-melech Shlomo. Shlomo, more than David, was the famous king. At this time was no wars anymore, and he built Beit HaMikdash, he was wise more than anybody else before, and everybody in the world knew this, and came to Yerushalayim to hear his wisdom. So Mashiach will be more than him. Yoter min ha-melech Shlomo. Ve'yashlimu ito kol ha-umot. All the nations of the world will have a peace treaty with him. Ve'ya'avdu kol ha-aratzot le'tzidko ha-gadol. Because he will be a tzaddik. He will be a pious that everyone in the world will appreciate. Therefore, they will come and will appreciate him and serve him. He will make miracles. Will be miracles that will be well known in the world. Anybody will try to go against him, Hashem will destroy them, the one who wants to go against him. וכל פסוקי המקרא מעידים על הצלחתו והצלחתנו עמו. If you read the Tanakh, the Torah, and the Nevim, you'll see that many psukim says what a success we will have with him, and he will be successful and we will success with him. Now, says the Rambam, ולא ישתנה במציאות שום דבר ממה שהוא ראתה. And here again, something that people do not think that when Mashiach will come, everything will be changed. He said, no, nothing will be changed. Actually, it's a discussion of the Gemara, and he brings the bottom line. Nothing will be changed at the time of Mashiach. The nature will be the same nature. Everything will be the same. But, ולא ישתנה במציאותו שום דבר ממה שהוא עתה, אלא שהמלכות תחזור לישראל. That's it. The only thing that the Jewish people will be not under the nations, and they will have a king, and their king, the Jewish king, will be appreciated by the entire world. This is it. וזהו לשון החכמים, and they bring the Gemara in מסכת ברכות, אין בין העולם הזה לימות המשיח, אלא שאיבוד מלכויות בלבד. This is the only difference. The only thing, שאיבוד מלכויות, that we will not be under the nation, we will be independent, and everybody will appreciate us and our king. Now, he continued, ויהיו בימיו עשירים ואביונים. Nothing will change. It will be rich people and poor people, גיבורים וחלשים, strong people and weak people, אבל, but, באותם הימים יהיה נקל מאוד על בני אדם למצוא את מחייתם. The parnasa will be easy. עד שבעמל מעט שיעמוד האדם יגיע לתועלת גדול. You'll not have to work hard in order to make a living. In just a little effort, you will do it. And what's the benefit? והתועלת הגדולה שתהיה באותם ימים הוא שננוח משאיבוד מלכויות שהוא מונע אותנו מעשיית המצוות כולם. I'll explain this later, let's continue. ותרבה החוכמה, כמו שנאמר, כי מלאה הארץ דעה, וישבטו המלחמות, will be no more wars. כמו שנאמר, ולא יישא גוי אל גוי חרב, ויהיה נמצא בימים ההם שלמות רבה, ונזכה בו לחיי העולם הבא. Let's have a few words about שאיבוד מלכויות. שאיבוד מלכויות meaning that we are under the nations, and they are, we're serving them. We are their slaves. Shibud. Shibud. We are slaves. Now we have to understand, it's not just that, like in Mitzrayim, we are slaves and we're building for nothing for the monarchy of Pharaoh. That's not the thing. Shibud Malchuyot, that when the rule of the Malchus, of the nations, and the rule is their philosophy, their ideas, are the one that the Jews are under it, willingly or forcefully. But today we are in Golos because many, many Jews today think, their thinking is a Goyish thinking. What's right, what's wrong, what should I strive to, what my goal in life, this is Sheibud Malchuyot. And because of this Sheibud Malchuyot, people do not do, the Jews do not do what's right. Because they have doubts if the Jewish values are right or the other values, the general values are right. Aside from the fact that we are out of Eretz Israel and we do not have Bet HaMikdash, meaning that many of the mitzvot of the Torah relate to mitzvot atluyot ba'aretz. You could do it only in Eretz Israel. And many of them could be possible to perform only when you have Bet HaMikdash. All of this we do not have today, and that called Shibud Malchuyot. We are under the nations, and why we are under the nations? Because of us, not because of them. Umipnei chataeinu galinu me'artzenu. Because of our sins, they got power, and we are under them. So this is the major thing that doesn't change at the time of Mashiach. We'll go back to Eretz Israel, we'll have Bet HaMikdash, and we will be able to fulfill all the mitzvot atluyot ba'aretz. This is what it says over here. והתועלת הגדולה שתהיה באותם הימים, the big benefit, הוא שננוח משיבוד מלכויות, שהוא מונע אותנו, the fact that we are in this state of שיבוד מלכויות, מונע אותנו, it prevents us מעשיית המצוות כולם. ותהיה החוכמה רבה. The most popular thing will be wisdom. Wisdom. But not just general wisdom, to know how the technical, physical creation works. The wisdom of Hashem. the wisdom of the meaning of the world, all of this will be a lot, and everyone will know it. And will be, of course, no more wars. Because the wars, all the wars, are because people do not, why people go to fight? Even individuals. What caused a fight between somebody and their friend? Because nobody knows what their exact place in the system. Everybody thinks that the other person take something that belongs to me. So they go to a fight. When the truth will be so clear, everyone will know exactly what their place in the system, it will be... everybody will understand that if they will do what they should do, the entire thing will be successful. Therefore, will be no more wars. Okay, continue the Rambam. V'amashiach yamut. V'imloch bno tachtav uven bno. And this is also one of the things. If you remember, we spoke in the beginning about the 13 principles. The 12 is Mashiach. The 13 is Tchiyat HaMeitim. Right? Many people mix this together and say, when Mashiach will come, will be Tchiyat HaMeitim and nobody will die. Not true. Not true. It's two different things. Mashiach will come before Tchiyat HaMeitim. Tchiyat HaMeitim will be the last thing before the end of the 6,000. But he says that the Mashiach himself will be a mortal person. He will rule for a long time, but he will die at the end. Or it's possible that he will die. וימלוך בנו תחתיו ובן בנו. הוא כבר בישר הנביא את מיתתו. לא יקרה ולא ירוץ עד ישים בארץ משפט. So he brings a passage that shows that the Mashiach is, could be mortal. I'm saying could, because depend when Mashiach will come. As we said, the Geula could be even before the time. And if it will be before, the Mashiach will live for a long time, but he will die like David HaMelech died, and Shlomo HaMelech died, right? But if Mashiach will come at the end, and it's up to us if we will be Zoyche before or after, he might just, you know, come right before Tchiyas Amazing. And then, not that he, the Mashiach, will not die, everybody will not die, because Mashiach Tchiyat HaMeitim. But here he made the order that if Mashiach will come before Tchiyat HaMeitim, he will die, and then will be Tchiyat HaMeitim. V'yarich malchuto yamim rabim ad meod. V'yarchu chaye bnei adam gam ken. People will live longer. Why? He says something very interesting. Lefi shekshiyasuru ha-de'agot v'ha-yegunot, yarchu yamei adam. Very interesting. What is the cause of death?
Sin.
Stress. It's written over here. And he says, when will be no more Shibut Galuyot, we'll be in the optimal state, will be no stress. Will be no stress. Naturally, people will live longer. So people do not die because of illness, physical illness. He was a doctor. He was himself a physician, right? So he said it's because people are worried. People are under stress. That would make their life shorter. At the time of Mashiach, when everything will be in the right state, the right level, naturally, people will live longer, yeah.
Do all these things apply to the Gaon as well?
What all of this?
That they will live longer, that they will understand their place in the world, that they will have more chachma.
Absolutely. It's written clearly in the Navin. Look at Yeshayahu Perek Bet, he will say, and in Zechariah, he will say that at the end of days, by the way, there is another big event that will take place parallel to the coming of Mashiach or a little bit before that, and this is Milchemet Gog Umagog, the war of Gog Umagog. And the war of Gog Umagog, the bottom line of it, the result of it will be that all the nation that will left after will understand the truth and will understand that the only thing is that the Jews was right. I mean, their philosophy was right during the history. And if they want to be part of this optimal thing, they should be under the Jews and under the Mashiach, and they will understand everything. They will not become Jewish, but they will... they have some room at that time, if they will serve the right purpose. And that's what's going to happen. And therefore, they're including also that they will live a long time, but they will be the servant of the Jewish people. It's mentioned in the Tanakh many, many places. Okay.
What does it mean they'll be the servant?
You mean philosophically, like we are now to them, or?
Everywhere, everything, in all aspects. I mean, we have to know today, that's a whole big thing by itself. I don't know how long we could go on this. You have to know, the Torah were not giving only to the Jews. I'm trying to explain this. The Torah were not given only to the Jews. Torah, the meaning of the word Torah is instructions. Instructions for a human being. Now, there is something very famous, you all heard about it, Sheva Mitzvot B'nei Noach. Seven, okay. Now, the going today do not keep Sheva Mitzvot B'nei Noach, the vast majority of them. They believe in stupidities and things that's wrong. Christians, Bichlal, they have a problem with the first mitzvah. They relate to a human being as God, which is Avodah Zarah. The Muslims are not of the Avodah Zarah. They believe in Hashem Elohe Avraham. But in the name of Hashem, they kill people, which is the other thing of the seven mitzvot Bnei Noach. The right way of a goy to live, of a Gentile to live, is to understand that there are seven mitzvot Bnei Noach and keep them. He do not have to be a Jew. He could live as a goy if he's keeping seven mitzvot Bnei Noach.
Would they be, rewarded for that?
Of course. The reward system is fair. And everybody will get exactly what they get. Now, every goy have a free will if they want to convert, to be a Jewish. But we have to explain to them before, listen, business-wise, think twice if it's worth for you. Now, you can fulfill your spiritual potential by seven things, seven mitzvot. If you will become a Jew, it's 613. Are you really ready for this? So therefore, we are warning them. But if they really accept it, and they understand the responsibility, they will be accepted in the Jewish nation as Jews. But at the time of Mashiach, let me just finish this. At the time of Mashiach, they do not have to be Jewish. But they have to understand that the main people in this world who lead this world toward its goal are the Jews. Now, they should do everything to make the life of the Jews easier. And that's what the Nevi'im says. What do you mean that what he says over here, he quotes the Nevi'im, that will be wisdom in the world and everybody will be dealing with wisdom. I mean, everybody will learn all day how the world is going to function. Who's going to drive? Who's going to be who's going to do everything? So the goyim will do it. Because the goyim has no part in the Torah, they will understand that their biggest zchut, biggest merit that they could, if they will serve the Jews. So if they will do all the technical and leave us to lead the spiritual, to fulfill our spiritual goal, that will be their merit. That will be the rule of the goyim at the end of days, at the time of Mashiach.
They have to decide before Mashiach comes. That when Mashiach comes, then they can't say, "Oh, I also want to be Jewish." They have to do it before.
Yeah, it's mentioned in the Gemara that en mekablim gerim limot haMashiach. En mekablim gerim, there will be no more conversion at the time of Mashiach. Because, right.
I want it.
Because even today, when a goy really wants to become a Jew, he should become a Jew because it's true, not because it's beneficial. At the time of... Therefore, en mekablim gerim limot haMashiach. Okay, let's continue. After he says that people will live long life because there will be no stress, it could be that his kingdom will be long time. Okay, fine, let's get this. Why are we waiting for Mashiach? Not because we're going to be rich and we're going to have a good time, good life. Meaning Cadillacs, Lexus. ולא לשתות יין במיני הזמר. כמו שמחשבים מבולבלי הדעת. Only the people who are confused thinks, yeah, we want the time of Mashiach because we're going to have a good time physically. אבל, התאבו הנביאים והחסידים ימות המשיח ורבתה תשוקתם אליו. Why they wanted so much that Mashiach will come? למה שיהיה בו מקיבוץ הצדיקים. That everybody will be in different levels spiritually. Everybody will be righteous. Everybody will be pious. Everybody will be in the right level, the optimum level of Tzelem Elokim. והנהגת הטובה והחוכמה וצדק המלך, and the king will be the role model of righteous, of pious, וצדק המלך ורוב יושרו והפלגת חוכמתו וקרבתו אל האלוקים. כמו שנאמר בתהילים, השם אמר אליי, בני אתה, אני היום ילידתיך. Meaning, the son is the most close to the father. So, השם will say to Mashiach, you are the role model. When I created a human being to be a Tzelem Elokim, I meant you. So, and everybody will see him and try to be the Tzelem Elokim, the close to Hashem. ועשיית כל מצוות תורת משה רבנו עליו השלום, מעין התרשלות ועצלה. We'll do the mitzvot with enthusiasm, without laziness, ולא אונס, and will not have, you know, use excuses, why we didn't do that, why we didn't that. כמו שנאמר בירמיהו, ולא ילמדו, ילמדו עוד איש את ראהו ואיש את אחיו למור, דעו את השם. כי כולם ידעו אותי, מגדולה ועד תלם. You'll not have to push people to go to Torah class. Because everybody will known and appreciated and have the drive to do it. ונתתי תורתי בליבם, ועשירותי את לב העבד מבשרכם, והרבה מאלו הפסוקים באלו, וזה העניין. Meaning, this is not, by itself, again, another big thing. Hashem says, this actually a quote from Yechezkel. Yechezkel said that at the end of days, Hashem will transform our heart. And he will replace our heart. Everybody will go through a surgery, of heart surgery. And Hashem will take the heart that we have now, which is a stone heart, and instead it will give us a real heart, a flesh, a lev basar. The stone is not accepting anything. It's a stone. And this is the heart that we have today. And this caused us to do things against what's right. At the end of days, Hashem will take this stone heart from us. The meaning of it will be no more bechira. No more bechira. No more yetzer hara. We will want to do what's right. So this is a big change that's going to be at the time. Will be no more bechira.
So then there won't be reward and punishment. So what's the whole point? The whole idea
that's
is
true. To that's true. The time of reward and punishment is a, it's a mean. It's not a goal. And when we finish the time of the mean, it's time now for the goal. And the goal is that everybody will do the right thing.
So how could you get higher?
Got what?
How can you get higher?
I think here is the time to get higher.
You could go higher and higher and higher from the place of. Even without the Bechira to do not good things, you could deep your understanding. Or yeah, you know what, we have to wait and see. Okay. I don't know how much time we have.
No, how much time?
We have another 10 minutes?
Yeah.
10 minutes? Okay. Now look, I want to show you an amazing source. Maybe you know it, maybe not, but it's worth learning it again. Chazal speaks about the end of days. And there is a famous Boraita in Masechet Sotah. At the end of Masechet Sotah, the last page of Daf Mem Tet, the Gemara bring what's gone, and it's written, and it's in the text, at least 1500 years. And the Gemara says, what's how the life will be look like right before Mashiach will come. If you will read it and understand what it says and read the news of today and just go outside, you will see that all of the details are here. Let's see. This is what the Gemara says. The Gemara bring a braita that says, give a list of 20 things, not good things, that gonna be the norm right before Mashiach will come. And this is it. Be'ikvot Mashiach. Ikvot Mashiach meaning the footstep of Mashiach. Meaning, you could hear, you do not see the Mashiach yet because he's not visible now, but you could hear his footstep. Meaning he's walking, you could hear his footstep, but you could not see him. This is Be'ikvot Mashiach. What's going to happen? Chutzpah Yisgeh. ויוקר יעמיר, הגפן תיתן פריה, all of this. Now let's see them one by one. בעקבות משיחה, says Rashi, בעקבות משיח בסוף הגלות, לפני ביאת משיח, at the end of the exile, right before משיח will come. What will be? Chutzpah Yisgeh. Yisgeh is, will be a lot, popular. Chutzpah. Chutzpah. We know that. Chutzpah Yisgeh. Ve'yoker ya'amir. Everything will be expensive. Hagefen titen piriyah v'ayayim b'yoker. Be aware of this. Hagefen titen piriyah, when the vineyard are good and a lot, the wine price should be lower, right? So he said, the Gemara said that there will be a paradox over here. Will be a lot of things, but everything will be expensive. Against the nature. Umalchut te'afech leminut. Minut in Chazal is a kfira, is denying Hashem. This is minut. Like velaminim velaminim velamalshinim al ti tikva. Minim is actually, when Chazal put this together, I mean, this bracha, this is the 19th bracha of Shmoneh Esrei, right? So it was, the Sanhedrin put it together because of Christianity. When the Christians, and the first Christians we have to remember were Jewish. Yeshua and his disciples were Jewish. But they tried to deny Torah Hashem and change the Torah, right? So what's written here is amazing. At the end of days, Hamalchut, meaning the rulers of the Jewish people, will be deniers.
We see that.
Sir. Will be kufrin. And when you see it, you just see it in the last 100 years. That, you know, I could say that as an Israeli, I came from there. But you have to know the entire system. Many, many Americans here, you know, good people think, you know, Israel, the state of Israel is the ideal. It's far from being ideal. The system or the rulers over there are all against the Torah, against Hashem. The Supreme Court every day, the Supreme Court in Israel, every day deals with how to make another law against the Torah. And they are the rulers, the real rulers. The government, everything. Even if the coalition, you know, the from go in the coalition, it's not change it. The idea is the schools, the school system. You have no clue what's going on over there. They made, in the last 70 years, a school system that teach children, Jewish children, kfira. In the elementary school, in the high school, for sure in the university. This is amazing, and Chazal saw it. And they said, Malchut, meaning, will be Malchut, a Jewish leaders, but they will be koifrim. Okay? Ve'en tochachat. You could not say to somebody you're wrong. Nobody will listen to you, right? Ve'en tochachat. Bet avad yeh leznut. People will gather together. At the old time, when somebody wants to perform znut, they want, you know, they go hiding themselves and, you know, they do avera besetel.
They're ashamed.
They were ashamed. That will be the, people will go together to movie theater, to pub, to clubs, in order to do it in public. And that will be the thing. It was never before, but we see it today. Now here there are very interesting two things. V'hagalil yecharev. In different nuschot, instead of vet over here, there is a vav. And it's mentioned in the nuschot before. It's not today somebody changed it. It's mentioned. And it says something, I don't want to be, if you hear the news of today, in Israel, one of the things that just in the last few days, become, it was always there, but it was asleep, now it's awaked, is the Hezbollah from Lebanon and from the Golan Heights. So, and we know, after the last war that we have in Gaza, there were the tunnels under the ground. One of the biggest fear now, today, among the Jews who live in the north of the country, that there are some tunnels like that from the Hezbollah. I don't know where it's going, but it says over here that right before Mashiach will come, Hagalil is all the north of Israel. Yecharev, Hashem Yishmo. Ve'agolan Yeshom. Agolan will be no Jews in the Golan. That's not exactly the situation now, but it's really not something, you know, very far. Anshei HaGvul, if you know in Israel, there is something called Mishmar HaGvul, the border soldiers. Usually where they're supposed to be in the borders, right? It says over here that the soldiers that will be in the border will not be in the border. They will go into the cities, not in the border. Velo yechonanu, and they will be the target. Again, if you hear the news in Israel today.
Into the cities, the Arab cities or into the Israeli cities? Israeli
both, cities. Both. And they are the target. They're targeting the soldiers. They're not targeting the civilians. They're targeting the soldiers that's supposed to protect us, right? And it's amazing, you know, you do not need to read the newspapers. All the headlines of the newspapers was written in the Gemara 1500 years ago. Each one of those. V'chokhmot ha-sofrim tisrach. Sofrim is Talmid ha-chachamim. Nobody will appreciate the wisdom. What are they doing? They're learning something that's not relevant anymore. This is the environment. V'yir'echat imasu. Number 11. Anybody will keep Torah and say, no, old fashioned, you know, that's not it. V'ha'emet ye'ne'ederit. Nobody will appreciate about truth. Ne'arim pnei zkanim yalvinu. Today, what is the trend? The world belongs to the youngest. Who are the oldest? The oldest are, their time is over. See, exactly. Zkanim yamdu mipnei ktanim. I remember when I was a kid, in the buses in Israel, old person will come, you, as a kid, you offer the seat. Today it's just the opposite.
It doesn't give
us Zkenim yamdu mipnei ktanim.
It says on the bus on top, bifnei sevat akum.
Used to be.
Yeah.
Ben menavel av. Bat kama beima. A rebel about children against their parents. They do not appreciate the no authority. Kala b'chamuta. So that is an old thing. Kala b'chamuta, that's a mother-in-law. The kala, which is, will be against their mother-in-law. Oive ish anshe beito. And this is terrible. The most close people to you, you should feel safe about them. It says, no, the most dangerous enemies of a person will be the people of his family. Pnei ador ki pnei kelev. And this is an amazing thing by itself. Pnei ador, the face of the generation will be like the face of the dog. What is the meaning of this? Once, when people want to describe somebody who lived very, very poor life, very not good life, they'll say, he lived a dog life. Right? Today, dogs are princes. Prince and princess, right? There are a barber for a dog. There are
a restaurant
for dog. Special food for dogs. People become so close to dogs. At the old time, people raised children. Today, people raise dogs. They no trust in people. They do not want the burden of children. They feel very, very comfortable with animals. And dogs, right? Now what dog? What is dog? A dog. The dogs today, I don't think the dogs got upgraded. I think the people got downgraded. And therefore they feel more comfortable about dogs.
No,
with dogs.
I'm sorry, you're wrong.
You have dogs? I'm sorry.
You're wrong because somewhere I read about it. And the dogs initially, you know, like 5,000, they were all wolves. And they slowly, a dog evolved from the wolf family.
Oh, that's evolution.
A lot more. No, they became with the, it is an evolution.
So there is an upgrade.
There is an upgrade. I'm
sorry. Okay, fine. Anyway, one of the things about dogs, you know, today we're facing soon election in Israel. And we have election here in America also. Right? Be aware of this. When you see a person walking with their dog, if the dog was not with a leash, the dog goes ahead, right? He's running ahead. So it seems that he's leading the person behind him. Until the dog got to a junction, there are two ways. Then what the dog do? stand, wait, and look at his owner to see where he wants to go. Pnei ador ki pnei kelev. The leaders of this generation are not leaders. They are like dogs. They're going ahead, but they want to know what people think. They are not leading the people. They look and see what the people, and you know, surveys, and they change their agenda according to what's popular. They are not leaders. Pnei ador ki pnei kelev. Haben eino mitbayesh me'aviv. And this is the 20 things. Ve'al ma yesh lanu lishen al avinu shebashamayim. So it seems that, you know what, it's so hopeless. So the only thing that we could have is Hashem. We have to know that this is actually the 21. The 21 thing is that people realize that nobody could help, only Hashem. And this is exactly what's happening today in our generation. And this is the time, and this is the Ikvot Mashiach. And be aware again, this things are not the headlines of today. That was written 1,500 years ago. We knew it all the time, and now we see that it's become true. So we're very, very close. There is a lot more, but I think that what we could do. Yeah.
Is there a mitzvah or a special Indian to like have a suitcase packed for Mashiach, like people say? Like, I mean, seriously.
I don't know about this.
I don't know.
You know what?
It's
meant something very close to this. Seriously, to answer your question, is mentioned in Sefer Achinuch. Achar ha-ma'asim nimshachim ha-levavot. If you do something, that will make you identify with it. But it's a technical thing. What actually we spoke about today is this is a real mitzvah to anticipate Mashiach. You could anticipate Mashiach only if you think that the situation that you're in, you as individual and the nation as a nation, is not good. Because if you feel comfortable and everything is good, you are not waiting for Mashiach. You are not waiting for redemption. So this is the mitzvah to understand how bad the situation is, how it should not be like this, and wish and daven and pray that Hashem will send Mashiach. B'mheira b'yamim.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Very welcome.
Very good.
Thank you very much. Are we collecting? Where was the 20 points? Where is that? Which
one? Masechet Sotah, Daf Mentet. Mentet Amud Bet. At the end, at the last page of Masechet Sotah. Mentet Amud Bet.
Thank you.
Now, if you want to hear or see these lectures, you could see them if you have an access to the internet.
Yes,
I have my channel in YouTube. This is it. I will put this lecture and others also there. I have close to 200 shiurim over there.
It's on YouTube.
Most of them. Here. Not the regular YouTube. This is the address. YouTube.com.
And what about the tablet?
Wait, first this. YouTube.com/user/Yinon Kalazan. And there is more lectures on Arachim website. Most of the shiurim are in Hebrew, but there are about 50 in English. So.
Thank you so much.